Well, folks, here we are. And as you can see, the organisers have really put the effort in.
It's been a really interesting journey getting here, because we're not specifically here. Not that it's boring getting here, but getting to this point and coming to conventions and talking about Yu-Gi-Oh! Bridged and stuff, it's been a really strange and twisting and very, very odd journey. It's, for a long time on the internet, I kind of ignored that this existed, you know, that people actually watched my stuff. I was really intimidated by fans for a very long time, at least 2 years. I would upload an episode, and as soon as it went on, I made it, because I usually set it to private until it's finished processing, and then I'll put it public, and I used to just turn the computer off and then just go hide. Because I was terrified, because every single time I uploaded a new episode, I would be like, this is the one where they're going to start hating me. And it actually took a lot longer for people to start hating me before it actually ended up happening. Next part. Sorry? You guys are trolling me? What are you saying?
Crapsule monsters.
Yeah, the birds, yeah. The birds are... Penguin Ex Machina with a troll. Oh, yeah! Stop using... Yeah. That was my good friends Kevifer and Shady Box. They were actually present for the premiere of that episode at Otakon. And they actually started trolling me as soon as the episode finished showing. it felt like I was on YouTube again. I don't know how I got to this point. It's really, really strange for me to think that there's some sort of following out there. The only time I really actually came out of my shell was when I actually got to talking to my friends, Team 4 Star, who do Dragon Ball Z Abridged. Do you guys know them? Crows? No, Crows isn't involved with Team 4 Star, but Crows is a good friend of mine who... he's kind of the guy who actually created the website that you guys might have visited, yugioabridged.com. That's where they started like having forums and like selling t-shirts and stuff. And that was another thing that I tried to ignore for a long time, but then I realized, you know, there's an actual demand for this sort of thing, and there's an actual love and a passion for this sort of thing, which I still find completely bewildering. I mean, I'm shocked that you guys are even here. I mean, there's a really great maid cafe opening right now. You guys can be enjoying food. The first anime I watched, it's a toss-up. I think Dominion Tank Police is technically the first one I saw. You guys know Dominion Tank Police? Masamune Shirai, the creator of Ghost in the Shell. Because back in the day at school, like, anime was this thing that people passed around like as like VHS tapes, and like nobody quite knew what they were. And I borrowed one, which was Dominion Tank Police, which had the Cat Sisters doing an erotic dance in front of a large SWAT team. That was kind of a memorable image, and it got me confused. But the first one I ever really like watched religiously, you might say, was Tenchi Muyo.
Oh, Tenchi Muyo! I love that!
The original Tenchi Muyo. I mean, I've seen Tenchi Universe and Tenchi Tokyo, but the classic Tenchi Muyo OVA, or OAV, I don't know how you say it, the original act is something that's very dear to me. I love those characters in that series and that story. And I have the manga and everything. I love that series. And I would love one day to sit down and do a parody of Tenchi Muyo.
Oh,
do it now?
I don't know. I see much.
If you want to sit down without having watched it in a while. And... Tenchi! That's Tenchi. I don't know what I'd do. yeah, I'd love to do something with Tenshin Muyo, but it's difficult because of the predominantly female cast. I don't know if you've seen Yu-Gi-Oh! Abridged, but the female voices tend to leave something to be desired.
Use Masako!
Would you be okay without Masako? yeah, Tenshin Muyo, Dominion Tank Police, all the old stuff, basically, that was like back in the 80s. I love, manga-wise, I love Gunsmith Cats. I think that's a great series. You, sir.
Have you got any advice for fellow abridgers?
Fellow abridgers, advice. I always struggle to think of good advice for stuff like that. Basically, do it because you love doing it. Don't do it for the wrong reasons, is the best advice I can give you. And I'm not saying that you would do that, but the wrong reasons, in my opinion, are doing it hoping to get attention or subscribers or to be invited to a convention. And I know that, you know, there aren't that many people who do that, but I have encountered people who do expect that sort of thing to go hand in hand with it. And really, you kind of have, abridging itself has become a really oversaturated thing. And even if people don't really like take to the show in droves, that doesn't mean you're doing anything wrong. And as far as like just technical wise, don't worry so much about getting a good microphone or anything like that. Just worry about the writing itself and the jokes, and everything else should come as it goes.
Thanks.
It's really just a case of making sure that what you're writing is funny and that you enjoy what you're doing. In the aisle.
What was it like first meeting Vic Mignogna, and how did you feel about how the whole thing kind of happened from him learning about you up until the first meeting?
Right, yeah. I did this video with a couple of plushies, two or three. One of Yami, one of Edward Elric, and one of Bosch the Stampede. Which is ironic because in one of my upcoming videos, Johnny Young Bosch does a voice. I don't want to spoil anything. But Vic Mignogna saw that video, which talked about him throwing up on women's boobs. Which isn't true, by the way. He doesn't do that. Feel free to go near him when he's drunk. But, yeah, he saw that video at an Irish convention, I believe.
I showed it to him.
You showed it to him! Said, "Little Kuriboh, your car is being towed." I don't have a car, Vic. I'll just finish the story. But yeah, Vic, he went out of his way to meet me, and there's a video of him encountering me at Anime Weekend Atlanta and hugging me, and I told him, "Please don't hurt me." I was very afraid. He was very gracious, he was very nice, and we met at a bunch of different conventions after that, and we got to know each other better, and at one point we even went out to eat together and went to a Thai place, and we... Not like that! Is that disappointing? Oh my god! Persona cosplayers! I'm sorry. I was excited. But we went out to eat, and he and I bonded over our love of old sci-fi. And, aside from that, we haven't really seen each other that much. I saw him at Comic-Con, and there's a picture somebody took, because he was hanging out in the Funimation area, and there's a bunch of Dragon Ball Z stuff there, because they were doing DBZ Kai, and there was some Yu-Gi-Oh! Cosplayers, and there's a picture of Vic Mignogna standing with a Jaden and somebody else, and the Jadens are like, and Vic's like, and I'm in the background going, it just sums up the whole relationship between you. But that's basically thank you for introducing Vic to my world. I really didn't know anything about the guy when I made that video. I just sort of threw a bunch of stuff together and I had to plushie, so I really didn't mean to make any insinuations about the guy, but yeah.
Where did you come up with all the personalities for the characters?
All the personalities? Well, most of them come from the actual show itself. It's just an example. This is good advice for a Bridger, is the best interpretations comedically of the character is basically just to take the actual character himself, don't change them at all, but make them self-aware. So, for example, Bakora is basically Bakora. There is not much different. I gave him a different backstory with the whole Florence thing. But he's still Bakora. He's still that same guy. He's still evil. He's still British. But he knows about it. You know, he calls attention to it, and that's kind of why he's funny. Kaiba is the same situation. He knows he has a huge ego. He knows he has a lot of money. He doesn't just like have that be his personality while he's playing Kage. He actually, that is him. You know, that's what he talks about. That's what he jokes about. And that's kind of where a lot of the personalities come from for the show. Sometimes I'll take sort of inspiration from other sources, like, for example, Quafio from Perfect Hair Forever was the direct inspiration for Darts, as played by Takahata 101 with the do him! Do him on motorcycles! Beavis and Butthead for Rex and Weevil. I'm trying to think of a truly original interpretation of a character, and unfortunately, whenever I try to think of an original thing that I come up with, which isn't necessarily original, but the Naruto thing that I do for the Naruto series, the spoof thing that I do, where he's basically just really loud! That's kind of original, but not really. But most of the stuff he says isn't like references to anything, it's just he's yelling. These are the only things that I would say, and that's usually it's from the actual show. Sometimes I take it from other series that I like, usually, or sometimes I just do randomness. But is that a good answer to the question? Is that a super question? Someone, yes. He's not David Bowie. why doesn't David Bowie have such an identity?
He's not David Bowie married straight.
Okay. I can't think of anything to come to respond around here.
Yeah.
Barry Kivas. But one of the characters actually uses a time machine as a card, because there's a card called Time Machine which takes the turn back one turn or something like that. And so the monster comes back to life as a result of using Time Machine. And when he uses Time Machine, it makes the TARDIS sound effect. So that was clever. And that was before Doctor Who came back, so... I think it was.
No.
Before Doctor Who was so cool.
back in early 05!
I'm sorry?
Doctor Who was back in early 05.
Oh, well, there you go, I was wrong.
Sorry.
Everybody's perfect.
I get all kinds of things wrong. But having said that, there will be a Doctor Who reference in episode 51.
Oh, yes!
It's the 11th, is it? Is the new one the 11th Doctor?
Yeah.
It's him who shows up. I'm not going to say anything else.